want to welcome you to All Saints Cathedral, and let me invite us to please stand as we begin our time of worship together in celebrating the life of our dear brother Barnabas Mwesiga. The choir will lead us in singing, "Great is thy faithfulness," as we begin our time together. Morning, We are aware that we have hope beyond the grave. So please come. Lord, use the music, use the words, use the proclamation of the gospel. Use everything and anything to glorify yourself. And this we pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let us remain standing as we listen to these words of encouragement. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he dies, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. We are also reminded in 1 Timothy chapter 6, as well as Job chapter 1, that we brought nothing into the world and we take nothing out. The Lord gives and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. God is our refuge and strength and ever-present help in trouble. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies and compassion never come to an end. They are new every morning. I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor anything to come, nor height, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. We continue to pray as we are. Heavenly Father, in your Son, Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us this morning and all of our days, that we may live as those who believe in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
We'll together turn to the order of service, booklets on page 5. There is that Psalm 42. When standing, we'll say it out together. Psalm 42, let's use the version in the booklets. And together we'll say, as the deer pants for streams of water, so my soul pants for you, my God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. When can I go and meet my God? My tears have been my food day and night, while people say to me all day long, where is your God? These things I remember as I pour out my soul, how I used to go to the house of God under the protection of the mighty one, with shouts of joy and praise among mankind's throng. Why, my soul, are you downcast? Why so disturbed within me? Put your hope in God, for I will yet praise him, my Savior and my God. My soul is downcast within me. Therefore, I will remember you from the land of the Jordan, the heights of Hermon, from Mount Pisa. Deep holes to deep, deep in the roar of our waterfalls. All your waves and breakers have swept over me. By day, the Lord directs his love. At night, his song is with me, a prayer to the Lord of my life. I say to all my rock, why have you forgotten me? Why must I go about mourning or rest my day? My bones have come also hard on me, as my force taught me. Say to you, O Lord, where is God? Why, my soul, are you downcast? Why soul is stuck within me? Put your hope in God, for I will yet praise him, my Savior and my God. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Please be seated, and I will invite the MC to lead us in time of laying on a brief, and soon after that, we'll have the eulogy.
Praise the Lord.
My name is Ankuda Brian. Grandchildren. Trendlands Limited and Year 2 Limited. Mr. and Mrs. Omodin and family. mkono. Mirama family, Coffee Football Club. Zambia Football Club. Class of 88. Uganda family. Uganda. Center, East Africa Limited. Semanobe family. Baseball and softball family. Family. Dogs Football Club. Thank you very much. As we proceed to the speeches and condolence messages, I'd also like to mention what many may not know is that, of course, through the Doves Football Club that has just been here, the sports ministry that we have at All Saints Catholic, mostly that is dominated by the youth, was it began as a few young people who were invited to play with the men at Nagasero, the team of doves. And it slowly grew into what we have now as our sports ministry. In fact, it was not a rare sight to find Uncle Barinaba on a Saturday morning personally slashing that pitch in Nagasero. When you read the things that were being written about him in the newspapers, but then you find him slashing the pitch himself, it is a true testament of the person that he was. Allow me to begin with a condolence message from Airtel as we begin our speeches. This is dated the 22nd of September 2023. Condolence message. Management and staff of Airtel Uganda Limited convey their heartfelt condolences to their member of staff, Donald Twesiga, and family upon the death of his dear father. We pray that the good Lord comforts you all in this trying moment, and may the deceased soul rest in eternal peace. It is signed Managing Director Munoj Murali. Also, for those who have messages in form of cash or contributions of any kind, I will ask Lydia to stand wherever you are. There she is. Please, you can pass on those messages to Lydia. Also, for transport, which we shall discuss at the end, in case you have any inquiries, please see Lydia at the back. Allow me to also read this condolence message from the Namagunga Old Girls Association, the class of 88, which is addressed to the entire family of the late Barnabas Mwesiga, and to our classmate, Barbara Kembabazi. Sincere condolences. The untimely death of our dear dad, Mr. Barnabas Mwesiga, has hit us with profound shock and grief. We have known him as a wonderful father, friend, teacher, mentor, and disciplinarian to many. We saw him many times during our school days when he came for school visits, and he was such a lively parent and so full of life. He will always be remembered by all of us for his unique personality. Always jolly, funny, down to earth, and humbly reaching to those in need. Indeed, he touched and changed many lives. The entire Noga fraternity continues to pray for you. He will be greatly missed by everyone. At this point, we thank God for his life and for all the wonderful years and moments you have shared as a family. Once again, we do convey our sincere condolences to the entire family, and may God continue to strengthen you all. Our prayers go out to all during this time of grief. May his soul rest in glory. Now we shall begin with the speech from his children.
To meet my dad, Mr. Barnabas Mwesiga. all. The late was my dad. This is a really sad moment. However, I'm really glad that you've all come, you've come through and you've shown so much support. It is really overwhelming. Thank you so much for coming. You've made this trying time much easier to bear. Thank you.
My name is Barbara, and so I'm the third born, and my dad was the third born of his family, and my grandfather was also the third born of his family, so Dimulain. I want to thank you so much for coming to be with our family. My dad is, as you know, a sportsman and super, super strong. So for him, I think all his life, he probably only was sick once, which is when he broke his leg, but he's never been sick. So even now when he was just feeling weak and we're asking him, what's hurting? He said, no, I just feel weak. So that's why he transitioned really fast. And so all of us were just in shock. And because he's like, even now, as I'm speaking, I just know he's alive, you know? Because he's been alive forever, so that's all I know. And so I want to thank all of you for coming. My father was a father to so many people. And there are so many groups that he's been dealing with. Am I talking too much? There are so many groups that he's been dealing with, you know? And all of them are like, no, he's our father. We are, you know, he was a father to so many people. So another person told me that if you go to any town in Uganda, there'll be someone who'll say that Coach Barnabas mentored me, Coach Barnabas taught me, Coach. So as we stand here, we are representing our family, but we're also representing all of you as his children. And yeah, we are so honored to have had a father like that who raised us. We had the best life ever. So thank you. My other sister, she's called Pamela. She's still in traveling. But on her behalf as well, I would like to thank you. She had two of her friends, they're standing with my mom. They've been staying with her. So thank you very much, Joy and Helen.
Okay, good morning. My name is Donald, and I'm the second born. Our first born is in flight. She's on her way. She'll be here by midday, but she won't join us here. So my message is very simple. And first of all, I'd like to thank everybody for making the time to come here and be with us. It's not easy when you're mourning and you're alone, but you feel much better and loved if you have people around you, and I thank everybody. But mostly I thank the Almighty God for having given us 76 years with this gentleman, our dad. It's very treasured, and I think, as the rest say, he touched everybody's life in a way. He had football, this club, this flag, this baseball, that. So he did quite a bit for community, being a Cranes coach and player. So he thrived around being around people. But he taught us three things which we all thrive through. That is, first of all, to be independent. And with that, you're able to do much more on your own. To be humble, when they say that he would wake up in the morning, get his mower, go to the grounds of Nakasero to mow the grass so that the players, when they come, they find the proper pitch, that was him. He would wake me in the morning and say, let's go. And of course, me, I didn't want, but of course, you have to tag along. And he taught us to be humble, and he taught us to be very, very disciplined. Being a sportsman and a teacher at that, the discipline was out of this world. So he taught us to be disciplined. But today, we celebrate your life. It's sad we can't touch you, feel you, be with you, but I know you're with us here somewhere. We can see you, but such is life, and we thank you for that. Thank you.
Thank you very much. recognize a condolence message from Zambia Football Club, but I will invite Mr. Salih to come and speak briefly on behalf of the entire football fraternity.
Dear mourners, today is sad news for the diminish of one of the greatest stars of Uganda in football. My name is Paul Sally Ogolimbo. I'm one of those people who played football in 1978 in Ghana, where we are with Barnabas. Barnabas is one of those people who were all in football. I call him a mentor, a father, because I played with him and he coached me. And later on, we were together in the Coaches Association. But what I could remember of Barnabas is the person who didn't want conflicts. Whenever the conflicts would not be part of it, and was the person who wanted things perfect. In football, during his playing days, I think he's one of the, if not the best left winger Uganda has ever had. Though he was coming from a lower club, but when we are meeting in the national team, you could really see how Barnabas was good. Though he had wars and other people, but to me, he's the most talented left winger we have ever had in Uganda football. In addition to that, Barnabas, when we played with him in Ghana, he also did his best. One of my teammates, whom we are together, is here. Asiimwe, you stand up for recognition. I think other players who are around here never played with him, apart from our former president, Yuri Samanobe, who is also around here. I think he will be given time to talk, because he stayed with him in Zambia, and he was a FIFA president later on. So, me, I want to congratulate the life of John Barnabas for what he did for Uganda, and he left really a big name, and that's why many of us are here. Thank you very much.
Thank you very, very much, Mr. Salih. Let us continue, and I will invite now Uncle John to come and say a few words as a friend and elder.
The clergy, General Florence Takirwa, and Mayor and family, Honorable Bahati, Honorable Chongo, dear mourners, Brian said that I come to speak as a friend, as an elder. That was the problem of .com children. Barnabas and I share a grandfather. And grandfather had over 10 wives. That's where we are coming from with the Honorable Matembe's, the Uncle Huntington. We are all here. And in our culture, you know, we don't have so-called cousins. We are brothers and sisters. And we come from the same cell. So, General Takirwa, as my brother, we usually talk, he calls and we chat with him. So, Tuesday evening, he called me. And I knew it was the usual call. And he went, we talked and laughed. Then at the end, he said, but do you know why I'm calling you? I said, but we have been talking, that's why he called me. Then he said, no, Barnabas has a pastor. I said, Tachirwa, are you weird? What's this? Just take all this time and just tell this anyway. We started that. As you have heard, we grew up together, but Barnabas is older than me by about 11 years. But as we grew up, we would hear that there is this man who likes football. And whenever he was on holiday, he would make sure that he coaches us. And he had that passion. As we grew up, we associated with him. As you heard, he was a bit reserved. And people think that he didn't like people, which is not true. As his colleagues say, Barnabas did not entertain gossiping. Didn't. Gossiping and rumors. So if you understood him, then you got up well with him. You can't imagine. I was telling people, and they didn't believe. During my campaigns, I saw him come home with 30 football enables, donation to go and help me in my campaigns. And he gave me over 50 textbooks for my campaigns and gave me some money. And he said, don't send it anybody. You cannot call such a person that he doesn't like. And he would visit. Actually, like a month ago, he visited me with Aunt Sanyu, and we had a long chat. But we just needed to understand his character. He has made his contribution to the country. When you look in this book and look at his profile, how many people achieve this kind of thing? And how many people are proud because of doing such, apart from putting on yellow and the club for you? And you forget, when I was Bahati, I'm just being sincere. look at this. This is a very rich profile to the country. Look at all these former colleagues of his, the players. How would we recognize them as a country? When this happened, Honorable Matemba and I tried to reach Honorable Mabungu. Mabungu is the chairman of what? I called him, he didn't pick my phone. I sent a message. I said, I'm not your constituent. I'm not looking for any assistance. assistance. But I'm telling you that this hard work in Uganda has passed through. Can you please pick up and talk and see what can be done? He didn't reply. Now, Honorable Had, I'm sorry I keep referring to you as the minister here. If you cannot pick my phone, if you cannot pick Honorable Matepe's phone, whose phone do you pick? I mean, if you're a minister or you are there to serve, not to be full of pomp, and we have seen it all. Easy, doesn't. That's why Barnabas has left this legacy. I even don't think that the Ministry of Sports is represented. I haven't seen, probably they are there. But that side, as a country, as citizens, if we can just erase such kind of profile, and Honorable Hadi, I'm requesting you to tell Honorable Mago to reply to my phone. And we even drove in that rain on Wednesday. That damn poor Tutu, I didn't know where they sit, to Mengo, left a message. Nothing. So, I think we should learn from this. Mary, I'd like to thank you. I was a young boy when you married. And there were these prejudices in Ankore. Barnabas has married a Muganda. Went to something that's still got to the Muganda, what shall we do? Those days it was very difficult. Now it's okay. Children can marry from Australia, Japan. But in those days, it's clear that Mnyangore has married Uganda. It was not easy. But he stood by him and became a very good comrade of his. I thank you very much. And I thank the children for what you have said. And even when one looks at you, he knows that you have brought up very well. I keep associating with Donna. I support his business. And we shall continue. So, I would still insist and appeal to government through Honorable Minister that they are not needed, as you see them. They are not needed. They are grown up. But as a token, and as for morale boosting and motivation for the rest of the prayers, something should be done. After all, I see all sorts of things, pimps on the streets getting all sorts of things. What about somebody who has made this? I'm ending here. I know there is a problem, but having been a politician, if I was called such a function and I'm not recognized, I wouldn't feel good. Better for an MC. Let me ask the MP for Kashan, where we hail from, to come and say, well, and I will remain standing here honorably too, so that we don't go in a long speech. After that, you request Honorable Bahati to come and speak. If you can reply to what I have said, if you have the capacity to do it. Thank you very much. First of all, I want to thank you for coming because Baganda have a saying that Muno Mukabi, ye Muno Dara. My message is just about teaching. The sports people talk about sports, the politics in Jonas, Dr. and Honorable Hati. I just want to give a piece of advice. I'm doing a study and I have this information which I want to help you. First of all, your health is your personal responsibility. And you check on your phones, since you have smartphones, you look for the meaning of responsibility. Not just taking it for granted, but you look for the meaning. So your health is your personal responsibility, at whatever age. If it is a baby, it is the responsibility of the baby to cry when he or she feels he needs something or she wants something. If the baby is sick, it is the responsibility of the baby to cry. Then whoever is concerned will take care of the baby. I've seen some of you parking vehicles there with alarm systems. It is the responsibility of that vehicle to make alarm and say, hey, somebody is about to vandalize me or I'm in danger. So your health is your personal responsibility. If you're above 3, an adult and above, it is your responsibility to look after your life. If you know your medication, please don't miss a tablet. If the instructions say take after food or before food, please follow the instructions. Your doctor is not your personal, is not responsible for your health. So please take care of your health. Number two, a body has a system. It has a network. It networks. When one organ is not feeling okay, it will coordinate and say, "Here, I'm not fine." Now, some of you, even when the signs come, you don't respond. Even when the system warns you, you don't respond. Please respect your system and respond to your system. If there is a headache, don't grab Panadol for that headache. It could be a network system showing you that either you have a problem in one organ and please do what you are supposed to do. Number three, from the age of 1 to age of 40, I'll put 40 because June is here. From the age of 1 to age of 40, people look for diseases. You look for a disease. If you are suffering from TB, you start smoking, it is you who look for a cigarette smoke. The other disease, it is you who runs around and you look for it and you actually get it. At that age, above 40, it is by accident, but most of those cases are for those for whatever. Those who take alcohol, you know why you take it, and you know how dangerous it can be. I'm happy with the warning on the cigarette. It says cigarette smoking can be dangerous to health, but you see somebody smoking even when the warning is there. So, the age of 140, you look for diseases. What about above? Above now, diseases start looking for you. Pressure looks for you. Diabetes looks for you. But the worst of all is age. Age. There's a week at the Corona Independence Park, and the president was inspecting the guard of honor. And he was in the security something. And with our sub, we are saying, hey, president, got a damn fridge. Hardly a week,
The same president was at Kororo celebrating 79 years. So we wonder, with all the security rings, why did the age pass? So, as you grow, you know that some of these things actually work for you. So, go and take care of yourself, because the message I got from Takirwa, how did I know Takirwa? I was with him in Tennis Parliament, and we come from the same area. He told me it is because of either low pressure or something like that. But this is a gentleman who was doing sports. And some of you, when you get this, they tell you, go and exercise. So a person has been doing an exercise, to be disappointed by this kind of disease, you know that there is a concern. So me, my message is about, please take care of your life, take care of your health. Your health is your personal responsibility. And finally, I've been paying school fees for the children in my constituency. This one knows. But my family and I have given a modest contribution of 500,000. Now that the commander in chief is here, he can take over the command.
I'd like to extend our thanks to Honorable Mary Karoro Okrut. At least that one picked our phones. And we talked, and she was responsible for the coverage in the press yesterday in New Vision, in Monitor, in Bukele. Why we take one for Mabogo, we also take one for Honorable Bahat Karibusa.
Barnabas, but I've known him by his fruits. When you see the fruit one of his sons talked about discipline, and you have seen the way they have been disciplined here, even in the church, talking about their dad. You have seen when people are paying respect to their parents or their loved ones. They can speak even for 3 hours, disobeying what even the church has done. But you have seen the discipline that they have. And actually, I have known Don as my relative, and I've seen what actually the father instilled in him as a disciplined person, hardworking. So we want to thank Barnabas for the contribution that he made. Sports. From nowhere, at school I used to do 100 meters and sometimes long range, long distance. But from nowhere, in my own family, our two boys have become sportsmen. One is in basketball, our second one is in football. So I've come to know about football and actually what it can do to you as an individual, as a family, and as a country. So if you think about the contribution Barnabas made, I'm sure that even the modern football we have in this country, the foundation was laid by people like Barnabas and his generation. And therefore, we want to thank you. We want to thank you, Barnabas, for the contribution that you made. We want to thank the family, we want to thank Mary for what he did to Barnabas and the children. Sports is a very important discipline. It makes contribution to an individual. It makes a contribution to the country. You don't know how much, in terms of cost of advertisement, actually when somebody is praying for Uganda, how much would have paid on CNN to advertise our country. So we want to value what you do, the sportsmen, and certainly value what the first generation of the 70s did to the sports movement in the country. John, I want to also register that we are sorry for what Honorable Mabogo, I don't know what was the reason why he didn't pick your call, but I know him as a disciplined person, as a sports person. Apologize for what that incident, and also to appreciate Mary Carol Good. In recognition of the sports contribution to our country, the Parliament of Uganda, and indeed government, we passed the law, the new administration of sports. And one of the things that is in that law is recognition of sportsmen and women who make a contribution to the country. One of the other things that is in the law is funding, because previously the sports people, a football or a club is going out, they are raising money from people from where. We are saying no, the new law, that government should actually make a contribution and facilitate these clubs, facilitate these personalities who are praying. So that has been resolved, John. The issue of recognizing sportsmen and women, and it's now by law that if you make a contribution to the country, you make a contribution to sports, you should be recognized, and there is a criteria on how that can be done. And now I want to probably we'll need to cross-check, and that will be clarified, whether those who were there before the law can also benefit from the current law. Then the funding of the sports activities in the country has also been enhanced, and I'm sure that the sports people who are here, you must be very happy, because most of the views that you gave us were incorporated by government and passed into the law. To all of us, again, the Bible says, learn how to number your days. Learn how to number your days so that you can gain a heart of wisdom. It's my belief that you learn from what the contribution Barnabas did, and you also make a contribution to whatever situation you are, in whatever circumstances, in whatever club or organization you are, should be able to learn how to make a contribution, and particularly loving one another, loving your neighbor, loving your country, and loving God. I didn't know that the two gentlemen stood together, but the fact that you came and you are here together speaking to all of us shows the love you have for one another. That even in politics, there is actually love. And John, I'm very encouraged that you could invite your colleague to come and speak here. So thank you so much. And abambara to end up basasibwa, Twesiima Ruhanga, habwa Barnabas. He has not only been from this place of the part of the country, but you have seen the immense contribution he has made across the country. He was actually a nationalist. He was a nationalist who loved his country, who sacrificed so much through sports to make a contribution to our country, and therefore we are here to honor him. Barnabas, we do honor you for the contribution made to our country. May God bless his soul.
Thank you, Honorable. Actually, Uncle John, I think even though Honorable Magogo didn't respond, it seems he sent Mr. Watson because I saw Fufa delivering their message. We have also received a condolence message from Doves Football Club and a contribution of 900,000 to help with the arrangements. Thank you very much. Yes, I will take this opportunity to first apologize to Reverend Ayebade. When we were discussing the number of speeches, I had not foreseen. But please, Aunt Mary, allow me to invite you to come and say a few things about your dearly departed husband.
I wish to thank you all for having supported us and even taken time to turn up for this. I'll not say so much, but about what happened at the end. But it happened so fast, and as they say, they wrote something like cardiac arrest. But it happened so fast, and we rushed to Zambia Hospital. And the doctors worked so hard to try and bring him back to life. You know. Normal life, but probably God, this is what God wanted, and he passed on Tuesday evening at Isingiro Hospital, still at the emergency section. So I want to thank you so much for the contributions, for all the support. Thank you so much. May God reward you.
Very much, Aunt Mary. Just a clarification, the condolence message from Fufa which is signed by Honorable Moses Magogo. Asiimwe is here, and they have extended 2 million shillings towards the funeral arrangements. And they listed a whole list of achievements and how grateful they are for the service of our departed Uncle Barnabas. And now finally, allow me to invite Major Takirwa. Hey, Major General. Major General, me, I wanted to say Uncle Konka, but has a more pressure ya politics. So, Major General Uncle Takirwa, you are most welcome to give your remarks, and this will be our final speech. You missed the wreath for the siblings. Bueno, I don't know if it's possible to give you an opportunity.
To the members of the clergy, our Honorable Minister, the political leaders here, presented by some of the Honorable MPs I've seen around, the family of the departed Master Barnabas Mwesiga, our friends, the mourners, especially his colleagues, the footballers. This is a very great day that our hero is receiving this recognition before God. As you've heard, he's been a great man in his own way. There is something the Baganda call akamanyiro. He didn't believe in that. Go straight to the point, do what is required, and make the day. I thank his wife, Mary, for giving me the first dance in my life. That was 1971. And I think by 8 p.m. I was already asleep, but at least I heard the music around. And since then, this is 52 years down the road, and they have been together. I thank God for that. As you've seen in this booklet, the last dot on the siblings happens to be mine. So, I don't know if I have the authority to talk about somebody who has more than 18 years above me. So I see him as my parent. I grew up at their place. And after growing, I thought I was very wise. I ran to the army. So in 1985, that's when I joined, up to today. That's also a very good and great thing, 38 years. My football was always with the government's enemies. So, if I've been a good player, that's good. If not, then may God forgive me. But he emulates the parents from where he came. His father was a footballer. And later on, he changed to the church, from where he died as a reverend. But besides football, he was a teacher. And this is what has been happening to him. Footballer, a teacher. The only thing is that he didn't have that white robe for the church people, but he was so, so committed to Christ. A great man of this caliber sometimes may make it hard for you to talk about it. But some of his unique doings. He was wedded here in Namirembe, but we held the reception in Ugarama, Mbarara. A very big distance, but he made it. So, to him, things were always possible, like the way God says. And he has again done it, dying without much pain, very fast, and it was done. So may God help us also to have such kind of chances. Now, I think to the government of Uganda, especially through my area MP, that is Mr. Nathan Twesiga Itungo. Go and tell your fellow parliamentarians that a hero of this nature should have a stadium in the district where he comes from, and it's called Barnabas Mwesiga Stadium. I don't know what the size of the stadium would be, but some of us would contribute the land if you assure us that it will be there. It's so great. Look at his colleagues. They feel possibly they have not done much because the tune of recognition hasn't been so good. I would wish to say that it has happened. This is part of life. All of us are through the same journey. So for those of you who may not be able to get to Rutoma Mbarara, thank you for having come to support us. Those of you that we shall be together, the distance is still there, possibly 4 or 5 hours. So drive carefully so that we don't come to Nakasero again because of our hero. Drive carefully, get there safely, give him his final send-off, and I think that's it that I can say. May God bless you.
Thank you very much. We have come to the end of the speeches. I recognize a wreath that came in, though we may not lay it, from the smart vendors. These are my old boys from St. Mary's College, Suri. The year of 94 to 97. And also Sports Outreach Limited. And I have a condolence message from Uganda Baseball and Softball Association. And now, with much humility, I hand over back to the church.
Thank you very much. Let's clap for Asiimwe. At this point, we're going to give in our offerings to the Lord. Please take note that this offering will be given back to the family as church contribution towards burial arrangements. So as you give, kindly be generous. Amen. Choir with us in singing as we give in our offerings. Baskets will be placed strategically so that you walk to the closets.
Yeah, yes. Is that it? Thank you.
Lord, we thank you for these offerings. We ask that you accept them and use them to especially support the work of your gospel as we go through this season, particularly the family of Barnabas. But also as I read your word and proclaim your word, may you come and speak to us in clarity and simplicity to your praise and glory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I continue to welcome you to All Saints Cathedral and all the people that have given us encouraging words. Thank you, and may God indeed bless you. I want us to turn our attention to the Word of God, 2 Timothy chapter 4. 2 Timothy chapter 4. And I want to read from verse 1. In the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead, and in view of his appearing and his kingdom, I give you this charge. Preach the word, be prepared in season and out of season. Correct, rebuke, and encourage, with great patience and careful instruction. For the time will come when people will not put up with sound doctrine. Instead, to suit their own desires, they will gather around them a great number of teachers to say what their itching ears want to hear. They will turn their ears away from the truth and turn aside to myth. But you, keep your head in all situations, and your hardship, do the work of an evangelist, discharge all the duties of your ministry. For I am already being poured out like a drink offering, and the time of my departure is near. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day. And not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. This is the word of the Lord. I want to talk about briefly being faithful to the end. Being faithful to the end. Whatever God has called you to do, wherever he has planted you, thinking about being encouraged, being reminded that it is not enough for us to start. It is important that we continue being faithful to the very end. And as I prepared to share this message with us, I did remember particularly two of my football clubs that disappointed me last season. And one of them is KCCA, that really, you know, did well the whole time of the season. Not very, very well, but as if the future was bright, you know. At one point, we were having games in hand, and I think the leading club was just 2 points away from us. So I was convinced that once we play our two games in hand, we'll be on top of the table, only to fail at the very last minute. And I think the same with Villa. Villa lost it on the very, very last day. It was sad. And of course, the other club is Arsenal, that gave me a lot of hope. You know, the entire season, for a very long time, we had a smile on our face, Arsenal supporters. And in the last three games, honestly, Man City comes and takes it away from us. I'm not sure I will forgive Pep Guardiola. He has overbullied us, yeah? I'm sure that before me are sports lovers. We are celebrating the sports lover. And the language that Paul uses is sports language. I don't know whether you have heard, particularly those words, I have fought a good fight. You know, I have run the race. I begin to think that Paul was a supporter of sports a lot, because elsewhere he uses analogies of marathons, boxing, and all these things. So it ties in very well with sportsmen like Barnabas, sports lovers, sports supporters. The language of being faithful to the end, I think we are the ones that understand it very well. That it does not matter how good you are, if you cannot hold the pressure to the very end, you actually can lose it at that level.
And so as we live life, as we do life, as we do the things that we do, we are encouraged to be faithful. Now Paul, the writer of these things, has come to the close of his life as if God gave him grace to sort of sense that he's coming to the close of his life. I mean, in verse 6 he says these words, "For I am already being poured out like a drink offering, and the time for my departure is near." There is an assurance Paul has that he does not have many days left for him to live. And he has wonderful words, I should say, to his mentee, Timothy, that just before he dies, Timothy must hold on to these words. I am not sure what strength Paul had when he was writing these words, when he was saying these words. It's possible that he wasn't sure he would be alive after putting a full stop to these words. Maybe he knew these were the very last words to Timothy. And so he makes it very clear. Of course, he has said so many things. And in this text, he particularly points out people who come and distort the gospel. They come and say things that are not consistent with the word of God. And so he tells him, "Watch out, for you must keep your head high. As you do your work, as you do the things that you do, do not be excited about exciting others. Don't be so much drawn into pleasing people, but you do the right thing." He says, "For you, keep your head high. I say these things to you because I am not sure that we'll have further fellowship together." And so he is facing death, but the tone we sense here, the atmosphere seems to be a calm atmosphere. A normal human being should probably be worried that I am about to die. They should be thinking about what they haven't finished, what is left undone. They should be thinking about how do we live our families, how do we do what we do. But Paul is not in any way scared or worried about his end. On the contrary, he speaks with so much confidence. Paul would confidently say that he'd been faithful in his call, and so he was calmly facing death. And so the soul-searching question for us this day is, how faithful are we with what God has given to us? As we celebrate Barnabas, and as we talk about the things he has achieved, the so many good things that we talk about, to the point of challenging government to come up and show up and show cause and do all these amazing things, as we reflect all of those successes, can we think about our personal lives? Can we think about our purposes? The reason why you are living today, are you sure? Are you confident that you would say you can face life after life? Are you confident that you have played your part? Paul had lived like a soldier, like a runner several times, fighting so many battles. Those of you that have studied the book of Acts, you will see that there are so many people who wanted to end his life, and you know, he went through all those struggles, his own sinful nature demanding things, Satan himself trying to tempt him and, you know, cause him to death yet from his call. But in all those things, he remained faithful. And if you got an opportunity to hear from Barnabas, those who have been close to him, they of course have stories to share. Hardships, struggles, days that he had to face. If he had an opportunity, he probably passed them on to somebody else, but he wouldn't delegate those days. Tough days, tough situations in life, but he never threw in the towel. He kept pressing on, he kept going, and today we have the audacity to celebrate his life. And so Paul would say, verse 7, "I have fought the good fight." Some of us are indeed fighting, but our fights are bad. Hello. Yeah. We are fighting, but our fights are bad. We are fighting with hatred. We are fighting pulling others down. We are fighting not considering others as better than us. We want everything for ourselves. Those are bad fights. Those are not the kind of fights that Paul fought. And I have not had in the testimonies anyone saying that Barnabas fought such fights. The fights we are called to fight are fights of faith, trusting in the Lord, doing what God has called us to do. And part of the work we have, therefore, is to seek the Lord and ask Him, what on earth am I here for? Because it does not matter where you live 100 years, life remains short. So he says, I have fought the good fight, I have finished the race, I have kept the faith, and what I am waiting for is a prize. I am waiting for my reward. And you will know that there is nothing that motivates as a reward. Again, talking about sports lovers, when you are racing and there is a trophy before you, you keep pushing, you keep at it, regardless of what is surrounding you. Amen. So as we think about the motivation for living being doing what God has called us to do, the motivation for living being life after life, how faithful are we in the spaces where God has planted us? And the good thing about death is it really reminds us that one day we are going to be in this place. It really reminds us that life is a temporary assignment. Death really reminds us that we all need help. Oh yeah, the doctors need help, the priests like me need help, everybody else needs help when it gets to death. And that help comes from the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus. Amen. And what is that help? That help Jesus Christ makes clear when he writes in the Gospels, when we read according to John chapter 11, verse 25 and 26. Those who live, when they believe in me, they will never die. But even when they die, they will live. Praise the Lord. So the preparation, therefore, for life after life is what you do with Jesus Christ. The climax, let's not be nice to ourselves because we are in the church. If you do not believe in Jesus Christ, there is no hope after the break. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. That is the basic truth. You have not yet performed well if you have not come to a place of acknowledging Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. You still have work to do. You cannot have the confidence of God to say, I have fought the good fight and I am now waiting for a reward. You have heard in the testimonies, Barnabas started the sports ministry. At Old Saints Cathedral. He thought, as a sportsman, what can I do to serve the Lord? I'm not going to wear robes like the Reverend and come here to preach. Maybe that is not for me, but I can do something with what God has given me. And what God gave him was sports, and so he used sports to reach the lost. Again, the question for you is, what are you doing with what you have? It's not how much you have, it's how faithful you are with what you have. Praise the name of the Lord. And I will tell you that even when we expect rewards from our Creator, God is not going to reward us according to how much we had, but according to our faithfulness with what He gave to us. Amen. And so, I want to encourage us, even as we fight in this life, even as we walk through life, yes, there will be faith-shaking potholes of life. There are going to be moments where it's tough, where it's dark. There will be those times where you're not sure you can face tomorrow. But with the Lord in the picture, with God on our side, I want to encourage us, let us keep fighting the good fight. Amen? Let us press on. Until we see Christ face to face, the battle is on. But the good news is that there is an award, a crown of righteousness. There is going to be a time where we recognize your efforts. Maybe not in this life. Listen, sometimes we work so hard in the spaces where we are, and nobody will recognize you. It's possible that you'll be the hardest person working in your space, but the award of our employee of the year will go to somebody else. Oh, yeah. Sometimes those things happen, but there is assured recognition by the Creator when He says,
faithful servant. And at that point he will declare, you have been faithful with little, I will put you in charge of much. At that point, he will say, come and share with me my father's kingdom. At that point, it will make sense. So the question again I ask, is your life preparing you for life? Would you be confident in the place of death? Do you share Paul's confident expectation of a reward? And of course, if the answer is not that clear, probably it is time for you to make things right, to put things right. The reward is not only for giants like Paul. The reward is not only for the prophets we read about like Elijah and Elisha and Isaiah and all those people. The reward is for everyone who believes in Jesus Christ. And that's the good news for us. I am the resurrection, he says, and the life. The one who believes in me will live even though they die. And whoever lives by believing in me will never die. No matter how difficult the fight seems, keep fighting. Keep fighting. We will discover that it was worth it when the time of the reward comes. So as we remember, as we celebrate Barnabas, let's touch into our hearts and think about our spaces, what God has called us to do, what he has given to us, and ask the question, are we faithful with what God has given to us? Would we share with Paul's expectation of a reward? And if it's not, God is gracious that anytime you come to him, he opens up his arms to receive you so you can begin that journey of faithfulness. God bless you. We'll continue singing that song, Fight a Good Fight, as we prepare to pray to God.
Run the straight race through God's good grace. Lift up your eyes and seek his face. Life with its way before us lies. Christ is the path and Christ the prize.
Thank you for reminding us that no matter how difficult the fight gets, those who endure to the end shall be saved, and indeed there is a crown of righteousness. We pray for your children this afternoon, this morning, as they prepare to travel for burial, that your grace will be with them. We pray for people that are moving from various parts of this country, various parts of the world, that your journey mercies will be upon them. We pray for your provision, that they will not lack anything as they go through this season. We particularly want to pray for the family, for Aunt Mary, for the children, and those that have been so close to Barnabas. I pray that in the name of Jesus, Your presence will minister to them comfort, courage, especially to say they are not on their own. And so, Lord, we continue to pray that you may grant us the wisdom and the grace to use aright the time that is left to us here on earth. Lead us to repent of our sins, the evil we have done and the good we have not done, and strengthen us to follow the steps of your Son in the way that leads to the fullness of eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Merciful Father, Lord of all life, we praise you that all the people are made in your image and reflect your truth and light. We thank you for the life of your dear servant, Barnabas, for the love and mercy he received from you and shown among us. Above all, we rejoice at your gracious promise to all your servants, believing and departed that we shall rise again at the coming of Christ. And so we ask that in due time we may share with our dear brother Barnabas that clear vision when we shall see your face in the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessings of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you, travel with you, that blessing never leave us, now and forevermore.
Amen.
Amen. I would invite the MC to just come and give us a great reference and what next after.
Thank you very much. For those who will be traveling to the village, there is a vigil today and the funeral service as well as the burial will also take place tomorrow. And for those who have never been to Pamela, the home in Kakama, Mbarara, you know the road going to from Mbarara, and then where Ibanda Road now branches off, you take Ibanda Road, and then I'm not sure in kilometers, but it will take you about 25 minutes if you're not over speeding to reach the town called Mwesiga. If you reach Mwesiga, then Diploma is about 200 meters. After Mwesiga town, you will turn on your right. There used to be a sign for Kyomugisha. Banana, 1.5 kilometers.
Thank you.
961-166. Thank you very much. We would like to express our gratitude for All Saints Cathedral for having us and for the wonderful message. Thank you.
Thank you very much, MC. I will invite a member of the family to come and collect this for the church. Together we have given 2,130,000 shillings. We all stand and require our leaders in singing. Kindly hold our great Redeemer as we come up.
Oh, my great Redeemer,